to know there's still a little magic in the air, right? Well, we'd like to try and work a different kind of magic now. We'd like to take you on a trip to the farthest reaches of time and space. Does that sound ambitious? It's a very dangerous journey, emotionally and physically, because we're going to be going very close to the speed of light. And those of you who know your Einstein's general relativity know that there's a kind of clock paradox which may happen. So you may think, or we may think, suppose we're the astronauts, suppose we think we've been away for just a year, well, we come back to Earth, or we come back to New York City. And you guys may be 100 years older, or maybe 200 years older, maybe a year, I don't know. Maybe we never get back. You see what I mean by dangerous? Get on with it, Brian, you're thinking. Get on with it. Okay, I would like to introduce you, if I may, although they perhaps don't need as much introduction I would like to introduce to you the crew of the spaceship we will be taking, okay? In the cockpit, if I may say. Hello to you all. Commander Roger Taylor! A younger Mr. Taylor than all this talented. Extraordinary bass player, and of course the astro navigator on this trip, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Neil Fairclough! Right behind me, and I better get this right. An amazing keyboard player, MD, and friend for so many years, and of course he will be the radar operator on this trip. And he holds in his hand a very time machine which will perform this miracle. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Spike Eddy! Okay, we're gonna sing? You can clap and stuff as well, clapping is good. In the days when lands were few, and the
Still ahead, we'll be rocking in the New York town.